So in, the name is Makamure. I'm the carbon secretary for the Toyota Corporation. We had an annual general meeting today. The agenda itself was a standard agenda, which dealt with issues of appointment of directors, approval of the financial statements for 2017. And the routine matters that are normally dealt with at the annual general meeting. The only special item of this, on the agenda was the company getting approval to repurchase its own shares. All the items on the agenda were approved by the shareholders unanimously. After the annual general meeting, the issues that are currently topical in the business, he gave the shareholders some kind of he also updated the directors on the current issue with regards to the Coca-Cola protein franchise issues. He not in resolving the issue. I think the Coca-Cola company is probably focusing on the bigger issues relating to some markets in Africa, like in South Africa, where they are talking about bigger issues. So Zimbabwe seems to be on the back of the process. Then the chief executive went on to give a trading update to shareholders. We had this the volume performance. Generally, he indicated that there is some kind of increased pull in the market because government's activities, the way they are funding bonuses, the way they are funding agriculture in terms of giving very incentivized prices, is sort of giving money to the consumer. In a way, once you give money into the pocket of the consumer, it drives spend on our type of products. So generally, the quarter was positive. Lager beer was growing some 12%. Soft drinks up about 2% in terms of volume. The only decline was in the sorghum beer business in Chibuku, which he attributed to the issue that we are converting from the standard Chibuku to the Chibuku Super, which, because you're now selling a unit which has a lower volume, that in some cases results in you recording a volume decline. But revenue on that Chibuku business was also positive. So all in all, the annual general meeting went very well, and there's some positive view coming out of the business, because even as we closed the quarter in June, July was also positive. And we could report that July we also saw some volume increases in both soft drinks and in beer. I think that's really what the essence of the meeting was about. One of the issues was there are issues with regards to the SCAD, as we have known it. There are some concerns about our consumers, about issues of, them having confidence about what is inside the bottle. So we are doing an innovation to introduce another bottle, which is through a returnable bottle, but it has some attributes that makes the product much more secure from a consumer's point of view. So we are introducing it initially in a smaller pack as a 1.5 liter SCAD pack with improved graphics. The issues which we had with regards to labeling of that product, there is a requirement that most of these products must carry a health warning and they must be proper labeled. So the pack that we are introducing addresses some of the issues that have been raised by either the consumer or the regulators. And we would have launched it on a phased basis starting next month, but I think it is important for us to launch it at one go in most of the markets. So we think by about October into November, that's when we expect to launch this new returnable standard Chibuku, not the Chibuku Super. This is the standard Chibuku product in a new package that is improved aesthetics. That's really what is happening.
So it won't have like different flavors like the Super. No.
The Chibuku Super is a completely different product in terms of profile. what we're doing with the Chibuku Super Choco was to put in additional flavors in it. There is some issues. We're on a continuum of trying to renovate and try and innovate the product to make sure that it addresses what the consumer wants. Particularly, you find that either the standard Chibuku or the Chibuku Super, they were our customers that were punching it, adding on some chocolate, some milk, and we want to try and come up with a formulation that meets what the consumer is asking for. That the water itself becomes transparent. I mean, most products are packaged in green or brown or whatever kind of bottles. But you need to assure the consumer that what the manufacturer is putting is what I'm going to consume. So the innovation that we're putting in there is mostly in relation to making sure that there's a tamper-proof lid. Once you open it, you are sure that I'm going to drink this product. If you find that it is opened, then you will know that it has been tempered. That's really the innovation. You don't necessarily have to see that what is the color of the product inside. Yeah. I think one thing that the Toyota as a company is proud of is that it has a very strong balance sheet. It has cash resources, it has invested in plant and equipment, and it is trying to convert this raw balance sheet to create returns for the shareholders. Ever since dollarization, Toyota has been able to record the profit in every financial year. What has only been an issue is that the profit levels that we achieved in about 2013 have been declining. So every year we have seen that our lager beer business, if you compare our lager beer volumes in 2013, they were about 2 million hectoliters. In 2017, they were 1.3 million hectoliters. So there's been a significant loss of throughput in the business. But with all that reduction in volume, the company remains a very profitable business. It is able to convert its resources into cash. At the end of 2017, the company was sitting on over $100 million in cash. So it's a cash business, and this cash is being deployed in banks so that the banks can be able to on-lend it to other players. So Toyota generally is a very profitable business. It has never made a loss.
For these and other stories, visit our website www.263chat.com. Follow us on Twitter @263chat and like our Facebook page, 263chat.